Hey everybody, welcome. I am Chef Sandy. I am the chef aboard the luxury sailing catamaran La Rev, sailing in the Virgin Islands, the Bahamas, the Leeward Islands, and New England in the summers. Today we are going to make something super fun. So this is kind of, you know, when you're invited to the big game and you want to bring something special, but you're not sure what to do and you want something different, here's your go-to. This is a spicy garlic chicken pizza recipe taught to me by my good friend Susan. And we are going to make that today. And that's going to be the first of our game day snacks. And then the second game day snack is going to be our ahi tuna nachos. So first, let's get going with the chicken. So the first thing we'll do is take our chicken. I've cubed it into about half inch pieces, and we're just gonna marinate that with a few little things here. So I have some garlic. We're gonna add fresh garlic, then a little bit of soy sauce to give it that Asian influence, then a little bit of rice wine vinegar, some agave nectar, just to balance out the acidity of that vinegar. A little bit of cornstarch, I'm gonna hold that off to the side, and then a little bit of crushed red pepper for some nice spice. All right, now I have my pan up to temp over here, so I'm just gonna give this a little stir. When you do this at home, if you can let it marinate for, you know, a little bit, an hour, you know, overnight if you like, that's best. But here, we're just gonna go ahead and put this right on the heat. It's important also to make sure, listen to that. We're going to reserve this marinade also, and then we're going to cook it off, and it's going to act as a little bit of a sauce for our pizza. Oh, that smells good already. I can really smell the mix of those seasonings. All right. It's starting to brown absolutely beautifully. That little agave nectar helps with that also, just that Maillard reaction. That's when it caramelizes your protein. The amino acids and the sugars are acting together in that protein, and when it starts to caramelize like that, that's just the key to the kingdom. Oh my gosh, it looks absolutely gorgeous. All right, we'll just let that finish up, and then we will be on to the next thing. Experience the wonder of a holiday at sea in the Virgin Islands or New England on your very own private yacht. You'll experience a fantasy-filled week of white sand beaches, amazing sunsets, gourmet meals, and the best time you can possibly imagine. Make memories with your friends and family that you will never forget. Email us at info@sailthedream.com or visit www.sailthedream.com for more details. Have you ever said, I'll take that dream vacation someday? Well, at Cool Cat Charters, someday is now. We offer all-inclusive private yacht charters at every price point for the more budget-minded traveler up to a full luxury experience. Come celebrate your special occasion or just schedule a family getaway in the gorgeous Caribbean islands. Sail the beautiful islands of the Caribbean and see why so many people just can't get enough. Visit coolcatcharters.com to see a listing of our featured yachts or contact us to learn more about the many other sailing and motor yachts available for charter in the islands. Okay, I pulled off our chicken. It's beautiful. It's all set here. And now what I'm going to do is take this marinade that we reserved, and I'm just going to cook it up just to get it up to temp, so to make sure that we, we cook it so we eliminate any kind of bacteria that may be residual. I know it may be a little bit counterintuitive to kind of use the marinade in that way, but it's really okay. I do, as part of being a chef on a yacht, I have to have a safety certification, so you can trust me. I'm gonna throw a little cornstarch in just to thicken this up a tiny bit, and you just do that until it looks right. It's my brother saying, till it looks about right. So that looks pretty good. Might add just a touch more. And then we will take our pizza and put it on our little crust, and then pop it into the oven, 400 degree oven, for probably about 20 minutes. Okay, so we're back, our chicken is finished, our marinade is cooked through, so I'm just going to combine these back together, and then we're going to be putting these right on our pizza crust. So first we'll place the chicken, and when I put that marinade back in the pan, I was able to deglaze the pan and just got all those little pieces of fond. That's the little pieces of the protein that's kind of stuck to the bottom of the pan, and that's really where a lot of the flavor lies. So we're just going to put this on our crust, kind of spread it out a little bit, and make sure all of our bites are nice and uniform. Okay, and then on top of this, we'll just place some cheese. This is Monterey Jack cheese and mozzarella cheese. All right, so we'll place that right on our crust. Sprinkle that out generously. I like a lot of cheese. Who doesn't like lots of cheese, right? And then that is beautiful. And then we'll top that with a little bit of toasted almonds. I actually bought these almonds already toasted, but if you don't have access to those, I haven't bought them before, but you can just take slivered almonds like this and just put them in a dry pan on medium high heat. Keep an eye on them because due to the fat content and the nuts, they can scorch. Keep an eye on them, and then as they turn a beautiful brown and they smell nutty, you'll know they're ready. We'll top that with some green onion and then into the oven at 400 degrees for probably about 20 minutes, but just keep an eye on it. All right, looks beautiful already. It's gonna be better once that cheese is melted. All right, so we are here now to prepare some special nachos. So nachos with a twist. These are actually an ahi tuna nacho. So previously we made a batch of our tuxedo seared ahi, and we're going to use some of that in this dish. The first thing we're going to do for the nacho, instead of a corn chip, we're using a wonton wrapper. So the wonton wrappers you can usually find at a regular market. Sometimes they're in the produce section, and they're just beautiful dough, and they're all rolled out for you. When they're wonton wrappers, they're cut in these perfect squares. You might find them as egg roll wrappers, and then they tend to be a rectangular or square or bigger square, but any of those are fine. To do this, you can just cut them down into a rectangular size. I like to take my pizza cutter and just cut these in a diagonal. I like to cut them just across. A couple of episodes ago, I was making a French toast, and I got a comment about how I did not cut directly from corner to corner. That's how I roll. So that's one of my things. So again, I hope that doesn't freak anybody out. But here are my little wonton squares. So I am just going to put these on my sheet pan, and I'm going to spread a little bit of vegetable oil. You can use any flavor neutral oil. I have a little brush that I like to use. So I'll just drizzle that oil on top and then brush that in. After we brush this in, we will add a little bit of salt just to give those guys a little flavor. And then we'll put into a 375 degree oven for really just 3 or 4 minutes. It doesn't take too long. So keep a close eye on these, okay? Some of that salt will fall off, so I kind of tend to salt them a little bit generously. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the rest of these, and we'll be right back. All right, we are here to plate up the rest of our game day snacks. So first we'll do our ahi tuna nachos. So I have made some wasabi mayonnaise, which is basically, it's just a mixture of wasabi and mayonnaise. You can do it to your liking in terms of the spice preference, for wasabi can be pretty hot. And in terms of wasabi, I really prefer the kind that comes in a tube as opposed to that powder that you mix with water. To me, the tube kind just tastes a lot better. It is a little bit spicier though, so be careful. To plate the nachos, we'll just put, and I have put my wasabi mayonnaise in a fancy Ziploc bag. And to plate these, what I'll do is I cut a little tip off, okay? So this has got kind of like a piping bag at this point. I'm just going to squeeze a little bit of that wasabi mayonnaise out. And I like to have enough that when I put the tuna down, the little wasabi mayo kind of oozes out because it looks real pretty. So you'll see what I mean right now. See right there, the little wasabi mayo oozes out, it's gorgeous. Give it a little press, and then what I tend to do is come back, do another little wasabi mayo on top just to make it pretty, and then you can serve this with a little seaweed salad. I also like to just take the tiniest bit of the seaweed salad right on top. I'll do that on top of two, and then I also have a little bit of tobiko. This is a flying fish roe. And I'm just going to top these other two with the flying fish roe because those colors are just so fabulous, okay? Then I also love pickled ginger. So just in the corner of the plate, I like to pile up a little tower of the ginger. And just that little height, when you make it kind of high like that, it adds drama to your plate and just makes it really eye-catching. So if you bring those to the game, I can promise you, you'll be the hero. You'll be the MVP. And then also our pizza here. So it came out of the oven. It's beautiful. I'm going to go ahead and slice it up. And we'll plate that on our little plank here. So I have my pizza wheel, which is a great tool to have. I use it a lot more than just pizza. So we'll just make a couple of slices and we'll get that plated up. And then we'll be all ready for the big game. All right. So I hope you enjoyed this menu. It was a lot of fun for me to prepare. This again is a recipe that I learned from a very good and lifelong friend of mine, Susan. So there we have it, our elevated game day snacks. And I hope you enjoy the big game. Thanks a lot. It's been fun hanging out with you. Please look for my website at www.yachtchefsandy.com. You can find all the ways to connect with me there on all the socials. And send me an email. Let me know what you'd like to see me prepare next. Thanks so much.